The new year brings new thoughts about furthering your education. The Quincy Career Center is offering some assistance with a special college financial aid workshop coming up on January 18th over the Thomas Crane Public Library. We're so pleased to welcome Laura Hoitt from the Career Center, and Mike Rogovin is here as well from American Student Assistance. And you guys are collaborating, Laura. Tell us about this.
Yes, thank you, Joe. Yes, you know, Mike came up with this idea to offer this workshop, and because the Career Center has the ability to reach such a wide audience of people that are looking for work or in transition, we thought it would be great to support this workshop and work with the library as well.
It's Friday, January 18th, two separate sessions from 10 to 11:30 and then from 11:30 to 1. So Mike, tell us first of all a little bit about American Student Assistance, what the organization is, and then about what's happening here on the 18th.
Okay. We're a federally grant-funded organization that works with college access. And anybody can, we're a free service, anybody can, you know, use our services. We help with admissions, financial aid, and that whole process.
The daunting task, right, of filling out all
yes.
the forms.
Yeah. Exactly. The workshop will consist of two sessions where we will be helping people primarily with completing their FAFSA applications, which is the free application for federal student aid. It's the form that all Title IV schools in the country use to determine financial aid awards.
Okay, Title IV schools are what schools?
Title IVs are the long and the short of it is it's mainly any school that is a public institution or a private non-for-profit.
Okay, so an institute of higher learning, basically.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
And these forms will be at these workshops for folks to come and fill out?
It's an online application.
Okay.
They go onto the website, and it takes anywhere from 15 to 30 minutes, depending on how detailed the person's financial profile is.
So you have computers set up at these workshops to fill these out right then and there?
Yes, we will.
Okay, very good. What is the process? What do they need to bring with them?
If people are planning on getting their FAFSAs done, I would bring with them their most recent tax return.
Okay.
In this case, most people won't have their 2012
correct.
Done, so right. 2011 would be fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's it?
That's really all. Well, if they they should have their driver's license with them, I suppose, and if they are not a citizen, and they need their green card.
Okay. And I'm sorry.
Oh, I was just going to say, and if they do fill out the last year's taxes, mm-hmm. when they get them this year, it'll make the process much easier for them because they will have been exposed to it. The data is saved, so it's really well worth them bringing it, not to think that they shouldn't bring last year's because, I have to wait till I get this year's taxes done.
Yeah, okay. And once their taxes are done this year, the process for updating the information with the new tax return is very simple and very fast.
Okay. Now, are we talking about, high school seniors that may be going on to higher education, or these older adults maybe that want to go back to school?
This could be anybody.
Okay.
A lot of times, high school seniors, this is the time of year that they're thinking about this stuff, but we also help a lot of.
I mean, with this economy right now, look at how many people are going back to school or looking to advance themselves or change careers. So, it really is something that for anybody.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, anybody who's interested can come in.
And when will they know if they are going to receive financial assistance? How long does the process take?
Good question. They know instantly as soon as they process the application. What the estimate of their award would be.
Mm-hmm.
The federal aid, which is what the FAFSA deals with, is based solely on the financial information that you provide. And it's so based on the information, they can determine within $1,000 what you qualify for.
Okay.
More concretely, further down the line, maybe in May, that time they should get the award letters from the school, which will have a more exact number of what they qualify for.
Laura, I know you'd like folks to kind of sign up for these workshops so you know they're coming.
It's always nice to sign up in advance. We'll have a head count so that we're nice and organized. We are always going to welcome walk-ins because that happens with them. We don't want to discourage that.
Sure.
So we just, if you can pre-register, that's great. Otherwise, please do still come.
Okay. Again, a college financial aid workshop, Friday, January the 18th, session 1, 10 to 11:30, session 2, 11:30 to 1, Thomas Crane Public Library. For more information, as always, thomascranelibrary.org.